Super Gold is almost here. And beside the fact that Vladimir Koloff will be entering the Super Gold Rumble, he's also defending his Pro Wrestling 225 SCC Championship for the first time since he won it in the Iron Man match. And who do I defend it against? Well, none other than Wes Warren. Wes Warren, I guess 60 minutes was not good enough for you, comrade, was it? No, no, no. You've come back for more. I guess you're still reeling over the fact that Big Vlad played you like a fiddle with Cold War. Wes Warren, you want to challenge me for this right here? That's perfectly fine. Big Vlad will take pleasure in ripping the cold-blooded heart out of your chest and beating you in the middle of that ring. Because there is nothing, and I mean nothing, that will stop me. On that very night, I will beat Wes Warren. I will enter the Super Gold Rumble. I will win the Super Gold Rumble. And then... I know you're watching. Answer me this. Have you asked him about me yet? Either way, after Super Gold, I will be seeing you very, very soon. Pro Wrestling 225 is mine. Needs more Koloff. Needs more Koloff.
Welcome, Pro Wrestling 225 family, back to Unleashed. I'm Spencer alongside Landon, and we are here for the epic finale of Honor and Pride from Gonzales, Louisiana.
That's absolutely right. We have a heavyweight championship matchup tonight as Christian Blake defends against your girlfriend's favorite wrestler, Van Vicious.
That's right. Van Vicious sort of earned his way, called his shot into this championship match when he defeated Rhett the Threat at Iron Sharpens Iron, but the game changer has yet to lose since becoming champion. So, will that streak continue, or will Van Vicious be our new heavyweight champion? We'll find out tonight.
I cannot wait. But first, we have a very special guest set to kick off the episode here tonight. Let's take you down to ringside.
What a way to kick off Honor and Pride here tonight. It's Jeff Vance, Spencer. And look at that. They look like they're ready to compete, Landon.
I am all in.
You think we got a new tag team in 225?
Look at the house. Packed to the brim. I mean, look at this. You couldn't fit another person in here with a crowbar.
Our debut in Gonzales for Pro Wrestling 225. What an absolute treat to be here in Gonzales, Louisiana. We are going to have a great show, and what a fun way to kick things off with Jeff Vance, Chad Brown.
Fantastic. Jeff Vance is getting in the ring. We're about to laugh so hard, we're going to pee.
Can you scoot down just a little bit away from me?
Great job, as always, to Alexis Windsor.
Going to be a short celebration for our guest host.
Landon.
What?
Sit down.
Why would I sit down? The SEC champion's about to come out.
Oh.
Oh, come on.
This is not his time. This is not his moment.
Oh, come on. Not his moment. Did you see the same match that I saw at Iron Sharpens Iron? Every moment is Vlad's moment.
The new SEC champion. He's not alone.
He's certainly not. That's B. Charles West with Vladimir Koloff. Here, this is a celebration party for the new SEC champion.
Who is that with him?
What do you mean, who's that with him? That's Ivan Romanov. You know who that is.
Ivan Romanov?
That's Vlad's best friend for the last 10 years.
You would know that. Why do you know that?
How do you not know that?
This is not good news. This is not good news. I feel like maybe...
He just wants to get a set in. That's a funny guy.
So let me get this straight.
I'm laughing already.
Instead of dedicating honor and pride to your brand new SEC champion, the is we celebrate some broken down old men that your stupid country used and abused inside of the rundown building where we hang up a giant stupid flag, and we celebrate them by bringing in a bunch of inbreds and free beer where they were sitting in this glorified retirement home where they will die one day.
Now, he has crossed the line. How disrespectful.
Your veterans are as worthless as each and every one of you. And you are as worthless as this stupid country.
The VFW Hall here in Gonzales is letting Koloff know how they feel.
This is what I demand. Right now, you little short, ugly Batman, you're going to get on this microphone and you're going to announce that honor and pride is dedicated to the honor of Mother Russia and the pride of pro wrestling 225, or else someone is going to get seriously.
I'd do it, Jeff.
Yeah, I don't know that he has a choice. Wait. Maybe coming at the right time. Anybody would be better than Koloff and the garbage he's spewing. Look at that! It's Gonzales' own Blade Boudreaux!
Blade Boudreaux? It's Pro Wrestling 225?
Yes, sir! Listen to this place!
He must be here to congratulate Vlad on becoming the SEC champion.
I would agree with you, Landon, but then we'd both be wrong. He's got to be here to shut him up.
If there's one man who is as worthless, as pathetic of an American as each and every one of you, it's this man right here, Blaine Boudreaux. Blaine, choose your words wisely, comrade.
I think I can do that. Everybody, have y'all been introduced to Vladimir Koloff?
Koloff? He's way funnier than Koloff ever.
I don't know much about you, but I can tell you here at Pro Wrestling 225 and in Santa Barbara, we're going to let you put down the great veterans that we have in this country. So, how about in Santa Barbara? Let's give them a little USA! Yes, 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 when I am standing in this ring, the only honor you will show is towards Vladimir Koloff, and you will not chant USA. USA! 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 My beloved, since you want to come out here and rail these inbreds up, I've got a better idea. I don't know if you've met my comrades here. This right here is me, Charles West. And this is my long personal friend, the boss of the crew, Ivan Romanov. Gentlemen, if you will get on this ring right now.
Whoa. Let me tell you, I didn't come out here or come to this building alone. I got some friends of mine too.
Yeah?
Uh-oh!
No way! Oh, man. Koloff thought he had a plan, but look at the backup that Boudreaux brought to his hometown. We know Mustang Mike and Gil Gracie have had absolute wars against each other in 225. Can you imagine them on the same team?
225 legends.
Do you boys want to fight?
Gonzales wants to see it.
Well, I say, yeah, get out, boys.
Oh, what a surprise. What a surprise. A resounding yes from the Pro Wrestling 225 family.
You shut your mouth, by the way.
What's up? What is the match? As a match host, we're bringing you an iron pride in Selma, Louisiana. It's official.
Does Jeff Van
Make some noise, Emma!
You don't have the power to do that?
He's a guest host. I think he does. Since when?
Gonzales, Louisiana. The kids of old school Mustang Mike and Mad Dog Gil will come to the aid of Blade Boudreaux to turn around and take these commies and send their ass back to Russia. Where y'all going, boys? You don't want to do this right now? Right now?
Listen, Chad Brown wants in.
Everybody, let me hear you say, get that blood tonight. We're going to put them in their graves. Everybody, we want to see the kids of old school. Welcome one more member. Say yeah.
All right.
I can't hear you if you are playing.
guess they want you to be a king of old school, brother. It's on, ladies and gentlemen, let's go!
What an announcement to kick off Honor and Pride. A six-man tag team match. Koloff and his army taking on the king of old school tonight. Unbelievable. That is going to be one hell of a war here in the PW Hall in Gonzales, Louisiana. I cannot wait. Here he comes, Spencer. Your girlfriend's favorite wrestler, and mine, is in the building. He called his shot after that victory against Rhett the Threat at Iron Sharpens Iron. This man firmly believes he will be the next Pro Wrestling 225 heavyweight champion.
Dane Vicious is dangerous. Landon, this is a man that can beat anyone at any time. We saw he went to the extreme to defeat Rhett the Threat at Iron Sharpens Iron. And he's got just what it takes to potentially be the one to dethrone Christian Blake. But will tonight be his night? Not if the Pro Wrestling 225 family has anything to do with it.
Tension builds as we await the heavyweight champion. And there's a huge question mark going into this match about where the headspace Christian Blake is right now. After a really difficult Iron Sharpens Iron for the Overboys, Christian Blake has held the Pro Wrestling 225 Heavyweight Championship for 294 days. He has not lost since 2022. He has won 15 of his last 16 matches in Pro Wrestling 225. We went through the summer of Christian Blake in 2023, and he hasn't slowed down since. And tonight, he faces a challenge in Van Vicious. And a challenge of also figuring out who are the Overboys now? Where do they stand in the history of Pro Wrestling 225? And we know, Landon, Super Gold is on the horizon. There has been no better competitor in the history of Super Gold and the Super Gold Rumble than the Game Changer. But this year, things are different. He will not be in the Super Gold Rumble. Instead, the victor will get an opportunity at his belt if he can defeat Van Vicious and hold on to the gold tonight.
Man, before he walked through that curtain, I was questioning the headspace of Christian Blake. Look at that man right there. There is no question. This man may be more focused than he's ever been.
If there's one thing Christian Blake wants to do in professional wrestling, it is leave you with no doubt.
Yeah!
listen to Gonzales, Louisiana right now. Not so delicious to the VFW hall tonight.
I think I just saw a woman pass out over there.
Let's put some in a drink. Are you ready for a heavyweight championship match? Official DJ Petrie getting set to kick this one off. Where's his challenger?
No hurry to get into the ring with the game changer, it seems. Hey, listen, big shout out, credit to Alexis Windsor. Incredible work as our ring announcer, the official voice of Pro Wrestling 225. Terrific work as
always. Van Vicious has decided to grace us with his presence to get this thing kicked off.
And that is what it is all about. The Pro Wrestling 225 Heavyweight Championship up for grabs.
This championship match is under way here at Honor and Pride. You guys want to see all of our championship matches? Make sure you are subscribed to Pro Wrestling 225 Unleashed right here on YouTube.
Van Vicious seemingly wants to start this off with some sportsmanship, a little handshake.
Nothing wrong with that.
Sure, yeah. If he was sincere about it, I'm not going to hold my breath.
You questioning that man? I mean, look at his eyes.
First time I've ever seen him without sunglasses.
I think he's a little upset that the audience is giving away his game plan.
No, he's saying no. I'm serious. I'm totally fine. I want to shake your hand.
Incredibly sincere. You know, growing up, my dad always told me never trust a man who wears the same color as Pepto Bismol.
Yeah, you grew up hearing that, Landon?
Yeah, I mean, not surprised if you know who my dad is.
Looks like Christian Blake is going to give it to him. There's the handshake. Very nice. There we go. Sportsmanship here at Honor and Pride at the VFW. We love to see it. Yeah, that's great. He's not a bad guy.
Oh,
okay. But Christian Blake was ready for it.
How about that atomic drop to kick things off here? When's the last time an atomic drop has been the first move in a wrestling match, Spencer?
Blake sends Vicious over, and oh man, big back body drop, knocking the ponytail off of Van Vicious's head.
I think two more ladies just pass out.
Vicious
landed hard in the back of his head there.
Yeah, absolutely. Vicious deciding he needs a break here. But look at the laser focus of the game changer.
And another thing I want to touch on just briefly, I mean, you notice Christian Blake is out here on his own. Conspicuous by his absence is Bredy and Landry, the manager of the Overboys.
Yeah, absolutely right. We know how important Bredy and Landry is to Christian Blake. I mean, the Overboys are family, right? But Christian Blake looks so focused. I wouldn't be surprised if he told Bredy and Landry to stay out of this one. I'm going to go in. I'm going to take care of business myself at Honor and Pride.
Christian Blake ready to do battle here. getting a little bit frustrated at Van Vicious. And look at Van holding the official in between him and the champion. I mean, how exactly is Van planning on winning the heavyweight title? And you know, but look at this, it's paying dividends. And this is exactly the same type of offense we saw from Vicious back at Iron Sharpens Iron. And it earned him a victory, which is why he's standing in the ring across from the champion right now.
Vicious taking all sorts of time, toying with the crowd, and it cost him. Nobody home there with a splash and a big forearm into the corner by the champion.
Saw Van Vicious. Van Vicious's head was crashing into the turnbuckle.
And a kick to the back of the head there. Clearly the target for Blake. Gets to the cover, but Vicious does kick out at one.
Yeah, that's one of those covers. He's not necessarily looking to gain a quick victory here. Christian Blake just trying to keep Van Vicious on his toes, trying to show him he's not playing ballet in there tonight.
Vicious pulling Blake down by the hair. Whips Blake across. Ooh, and an elbow there by Dan Vicious.
All the way from Miami Beach. And Christian Blake on the ropes here, literally and figuratively. In the early goings of this one, Van Vicious, look at this again, slowing the pace down. It's a strategy that's worked for him.
But this is what we've seen with Van Vicious before as well. Yes, he likes to take things slow, but he really feeds off of the negative energy from the crowd. It would be so easy to say, man, he's taking a lot of time. He's not focusing on his opponent. But I really think that fuels him, that hate that he gets from the Pro Wrestling 225 fan.
We've seen it time and time again, and it almost works better for him the more popular his opponent, right? We've seen his wars with Mustang Mike and how effective that he's been in those battles as well.
But Blake back to his feet. You certainly don't want to be stuck trading shots with the game changer.
Definitely not the game plan to go into in this one. And oh my!
As soon as we say that, a massive, massive clothesline from Van Vicious takes the champion down. He gets it to the cover and a kick out at two. But Van Vicious proving he is heavyweight championship material. My word.
I don't think I've ever seen Christian Blake hit that hard from a clothesline like this. And look at this, that camel clutch. We've seen this from Vicious before, doing that damage to the back of Christian Blake in the early goings. I think this is a really smart strategy. Wear down the foundation of the champion here.
And just when Blake was trying to get some freedom there from that submission, Vicious knew exactly what to do. Drives him straight back down to the mat, keeping the champion down. Whips Blake across into the turnbuckle. But up and over, Vicious lands on the apron. Oh, wait.
Lightning quick with the dragon suplex. Only a two count on that occasion, but who saw that coming from Van Vicious?
Christian Blake may be in trouble here.
Did you see how quickly Van Vicious is able to get up and over? Whittem and scoop. That schoolboy only got a one count, but keeping Van on his toes now.
Another big clothesline from the challenger. Blake tried to take advantage while he was arguing with our official DJ Petrie. But Vicious able to put Blake right back down on the mat.
Could we see a huge upset in the making here at Honor and Pride? Van Vicious looks like he's going up top.
You don't see that a lot.
I mean, with a man of his size, I mean, not paying off on this occasion. Christian Blake up on his feet, delivering those forearms, and wait a minute. Van Vicious at risk of falling up, crashing over to the outside. We have no padding on the floor here at BFW Hall.
Blake thinking potentially of a different landing for the challenger. Going for perhaps a superplex,
get him
but
right in the middle of the ring. Oh no, Christian Blake goes crashing, and Van Vicious might know. Up and over, and
whoa!
Arm drag sends Van Vicious catapulting him to the other side of the ring.
What a match for the Pro Wrestling 225 Heavyweight Championship. Christian Blake trying to stick to his winning ways, went undefeated in 2023. He saw it, iron sharpens iron. He was able to defeat Simon Phillips. Can he get a second consecutive title defense under his belt here in 2024?
What an explosive championship match that was. And this one living up to every bit of that one.
Rocking the punch, the second one from Vicious. Blake then goes low. A big forearm.
Look at this offense.
Champion heating up.
The barrage begins here in Gonzales.
Oh!
Plants him.
Cover.
Shoulder up. Van Vicious still alive here in this championship match.
But odds not looking good for Van Vicious becoming our eighth different heavyweight champion in the history of this company. Especially as that knee pad goes down. Christian Blake, you know, he's got one thing on his mind. Game over, no.
In the corner, but Vicious moves out of the way. Got him up in the fireman's carry. Oh!
TKO followed by the elbow drop. The cover on the champion.
Champion's in trouble. Oh.
Kick out at two.
God, that was close. Van Vicious has Christian Blake right where he wants him. Can he close in? Could we be looking at the new champion? Is he squaring up Christian for a game over?
No, oh. Went for a stomp instead. Blake able to move out of the way. And there's the second half of the Blade Barrage. The game changer now. Seizing this opportunity.
You're gonna get it. In position. Picture perfect. Just absolutely plants him. The champion retains.
The game changer leaves. Wait, hold on. Vicious. A brutal attack. The match is over. Stomp to Blake.
And come on. I mean, what do you think? You're not the champion. You gotta win the match.
You lost.
I don't know if Van Vicious had any intention of walking out of here as the champion. I mean,
Vicious awfully proud of himself. Couldn't get the job done. Couldn't win the title. And takes it out on the champion afterwards.
What a sore loser.
Just completely ridiculous.
Christian Blake already having a lot on his mind here.
Not the way I think Blake expected things to go here at Honor and Pride.
But make no mistake, that man stands tall. Still, you're Pro Wrestling 225 Heavyweight Champion. The love and the support
for the over boys. But Christian Blake, looks like he has a lot on his mind. What does this mean?
What is in the head of the heavyweight champion?
It's not very often that after a victory, we see Christian Blake by himself. Where's the celebration with Jordan Ja? Where's the celebration with Brady and Landry?
Wrestling 225 family, our biggest event of the year is almost here. That's right, it is Super Gold 8, Saturday, March 23rd at the East Park Rec Center in Houma, Louisiana. It's going to be an incredible night full of exciting action, including the reimagined Braxton Hunter with one of his biggest challenges yet, going one-on-one with a former heavyweight champion in the ring wrecker, Fordell Walker.
But that's not all. The exclamation point returns to Houma, Louisiana. Steve Anthony goes one-on-one with the defiant Simon Phillips. And the Pro Wrestling 225 Tag Team Champions will be at Super Gold 8, issuing an open challenge for their tag team titles.
And as you heard earlier tonight, Vladimir Koloff will defend his SEC Championship against former Cold War mate, the cold-blooded Wes Warren. We will have all that and the Super Gold 8 Rumble, where one man will earn a shot at the Pro Wrestling 225 Heavyweight Championship. Super Gold 8 from Houma, Louisiana, Saturday, March 23rd. Now, Landon, let's get set for the main event of Honor and Pride. What a treat, Landon. LSU Tiger, Josh Williams here at Honor and Pride.
I cannot believe it. Josh Williams right here, joining us here, our special timekeeper here at Honor and Pride. Absolutely incredible.
Well, Josh, thank you so much for joining us. And thank you to my coworkers for helping me through that. But now, I am definitely ready for the main event. Are you guys ready?
Josh Williams knows a thing or two about athleticism.
No kidding. What a special guest here at Honor and Pride. Oh, this is absurd.
All right. All right, Josh, I know you're new to Pro Wrestling 225, haven't been here a while. We always stand up for the champion here, Josh. We always stand up for the champion.
Lena, no one's standing up with you.
Oh, come on. It's Vladimir Koloff. Koloff's army here in the VFW Hall. They're about to go to war, Spencer. War. You can't deny the man, the SEC champion. He lasted 60 minutes to become the SEC champion, Spencer. You saw it. I saw it. He's the best in the SEC.
I think when you talk about the best in the SEC, you better be talking about the LSU Tigers, and Koloff better not get into the face of Josh Williams.
I mean, Koloff, you do know who that is, right?
big bad Iron Man Vlad and a real anthem for a superior country. Honor and pride, right? Honor and pride.
Honor and pride. The Charles West, the man with the plan here at Vladimir Koloff's side. That's right. These two together, they are the pride in honor and pride. And don't forget the Bolshevik brute, Ivan Romanov.
I knew that if Koloff won the Iron Man match, he would be absolutely insufferable. But this is even worse than I ever imagined.
What are you talking about?
We're at the VFW. We're at Honor and Pride, celebrating our nation's veterans. And he comes out to the Russian national anthem.
You've got a veteran in the ring right there. Did you not hear about the Bolshevik group, Romanov?
Yeah, that must have slipped my mind.
Happens to you a lot, doesn't it?
Oh, my God.
Look at that chain.
When you talk about heroes, look at this group right here. What an epic main event of Honor and Pride. Six-man tag team action, Landon.
Absolute legends within the state of Louisiana. I cannot wait to see this one.
Well, and Blade Boudreaux, what a choice for his team, right? For backups, because he picked not one, but two former heavyweight champions in Pro Wrestling 225.
That's absolutely right. We'd like to welcome at this time, obviously, it's the main event. You know what that means. Alexis Windsor here on commentary.
Oh, my goodness. Landon Spencer, it's been too long. I was so busy at the last main event, I couldn't join you guys. I am so happy to be here.
We are thrilled you are here, and I am going to quiz you on American football the whole time.
Oh, my goodness. I fumbled my way through that, but, you know, we got it done.
Listen to this ovation in Gonzales.
Can I just say the crowd has been on fire tonight?
A terrific crowd here in Gonzales. You're absolutely right.
Let's go back to Gonzales.
Yeah, I'm in. But here we go, getting set. The Kings of Old School have control of the ring right now. Doesn't seem like Koloff's army is in much of a hurry.
Got our special timekeeper here at ringside, getting ready to keep this thing going. And man, our referee, Jordy Pujol, is going to have a difficult time getting this thing started.
Well, when you talk about champions, I mean, think Josh Williams sitting right next to us, 12 touchdowns in his career at LSU, a really, really great career. You know all about that?
Yeah.
Those touchdowns, Alexis Windsor?
The touchdowns, yeah, that's the one.
Yeah, you get it. You totally get it.
Koloff's army looks like they're getting a game plan together before getting into the ring.
I mean, they've got to get in the ring, though. I mean,
that should be step one.
Can we get this? Yeah, let's get this started. Come on now. No more faffing around.
Koloff being a little protective of that chain, that flag, and that SEC championship.
Coveted. And as much as I hate to give Koloff credit, he earned that SEC championship in that Iron Man match.
Koloff just threatened me with a cannonball.
I think that'd be just as painful for him.
Koloff's army taking their time, getting set for this match. Curious who the Kings of Old School are going to start with.
I'm going to say, what a great move by Jeff Vance, our guest host tonight.
Absolutely.
Putting this match together.
Jeff Vance from Lunchbox Comedy.
Some rock, paper, scissors going on there. You two guys know about that, don't you?
That little three-way rock, paper, scissors action. Who came out on top? Was it Gil? Gil's going to start, the Mad Dog? Okay, so we've got the Mad Dog for the Kings of Old School.
And I'm still unsure for Koloff's army. They've yet to make a decision. Jordy signaling, we just need one of them. Looks like it's Charles West who's going to start.
That is the Charles West.
The Charles West. I apologize. The Charles West.
We are underway in our main event. Special guest timekeeper Josh Williams, great job ringing the bell here, getting us set. And this crowd has only grown as the night has gone on here.
Yeah, we have standing room only here in Gonzales, Louisiana.
What a main event. A war between the Kings of Old School and Koloff's army.
I mean, what do you expect? Vladimir Koloff coming out here at the beginning of the show, talking trash?
Yeah, I mean, just the most disrespectful thing maybe that I've ever seen.
Wait a minute. Koloff won the SEC Championship in one of the greatest matches we have ever had the honor to call to be ringside for. All he wanted to do was to celebrate that historic victory tonight.
He can do that without taking away from the celebration of our veterans.
It's not taking away, it's adding to.
Oh, come on. The Russian national anthem, was that really necessary?
You ever heard of Yes And? Ooh, it's Charles West.
I don't think you're ever going to convince him, Spencer. He's a Koloff fan for life.
No, it's ridiculous.
Call it like I see it, just like I see that hard boot in the corner there. Jordy Pujol asking Charles West politely to keep things in the center of the ring, but the Charles West going back to work on Gil Gracie. Charles West, the man with the plan, the brains of the operation in Koloff's army, plants Gil Gracie, and look at this elbow. No, nobody home.
Well, and one of the more interesting things about this landing is we haven't seen Charles West in 225 in almost 2 years. But you have to remember West as he gets splashed in the corner and is on the receiving end of a bulldog from the Mad Dog cover and a kick out at two. But Charles West and Vladimir Koloff, former tag team champions.
Exactly right. These two know how to get it done.
And Koloff not liking how this thing has started, a bit of a regroup for the Russians.
And listen to the VFW hall firmly behind Gil Gracie in this one. Gil going over to pay some respect over to our special guest timekeeper.
Koloff's army have got to bring it back into the ring now. Referee Jordy up to his 6 count already.
Right, that's step two of the plan. Step one was get in the ring, step two, get back in the ring. Yeah.
It's going really well so far.
Charles West back in. I think they've decided who they want in now. It's the SEC champion.
Sit down, Landon.
I'm not standing.
Uh-huh. Yes, Aang. Thank you for that.
Oh, and Mad Dog Gil Gracie tagging in Mustang Mike now.
Well, you know, honestly, the biggest Mustang Mike fan in the building, Vladimir Koloff, wearing the Boom Man's colors here today.
Yeah, maybe unintentionally, the resemblance there. But we've seen Mustang Mike and Vladimir Koloff go at it before.
Two absolute powerhouses here. You talk about SEC championship history. I'll never forget when Mustang Mike won the SEC championship.
Right, and Koloff was the one to take that title away from Mustang Mike for his first SEC championship reign. So we know
one of the greatest.
I think that's not true. I think that was followed up by Jordan Ja with an even better SEC championship game.
Take nothing away from Jordan Ja, absolutely one of the best competitors ever in the history of Pro Wrestling 225. Vladimir Koloff, the better at Iron Sharpens Iron, with 3 points in that 60-minute Ironman match, enough to get the victory.
we've all talked about how great that match was. All four competitors are so amazing, but I'm really interested to see what Koloff does now he has this title. Where is he going to take it to next?
Right now, he needs to be focused on Mustang Mike because he's got suplex in the center of the ring. Mustang Mike with the cover and a kick out at one. And Koloff backing off. But Alexis Winter, to your point, Koloff said that winning the SEC championship was just step one of his destiny. He's trying to become the first man to hold both the SEC championship and the heavyweight championship at the same time. And we've got Super Bowl 8 on the horizon. So things might just be coming up Koloff here, whether we like it or not.
Absolutely. Especially if step two is to get in the ring.
Right.
Well, just let me take you back to Super Bowl 7. And wait a minute, we've got a quick roll up here. Koloff in trouble. A two count. Let me take you back, if I can, to Super Bowl 7. There were two men remaining right there at the end, Christian Blake and that man right there, Vladimir Koloff. He knows how to win at Super Bowl. He was this close, Spencer.
Well, you'd say he knows how to win. He knows how to finish runner-up. He's proven that.
Now, let's see. This is Ivan Romanov we have now in the ring representing Koloff's arm.
The Bolshevik group.
And Blade Boudreaux. Yeah, that's right, Blade Boudreaux, the hometown boy here in Gonzales in Sanama. Side headlock now on Romanoff.
Looks like someone's taking some blades to his jeans. It's hard, hard side headlock here. Romanoff pushes off.
That was the worst joke I've ever
heard. It was pretty bad.
Almost with the arm drag, but Blade Boudreaux holds on that strong foundation. How about a hip toss for Blade Boudreaux?
And a
look
drop
at that
kick.
Drop kick. Who saw that coming?
Cover.
Only a two count.
Kick out at two. Really able to get to that height on that drop kick, taking Romanoff down. Romanoff in trouble as the Mad Dog back in the ring.
Shots to the midsection of Romanoff. Romanoff in dire straits here. The fresh Mad Dog's one of the most dangerous competitors you can be against in a Pro Wrestling 225 ring.
Absolutely right about that. Takes Romanoff down. Big fist drop. Cover.
And comes the champion.
What is that? Koloff.
That was a lucky save, though. I think that would have been a three count.
Yeah, I think so. And Koloff knew it. That's why he jumped in. Not as much faith in his 10-year bestie from Russia.
Have you ever seen a tag team match before?
Once or twice in my life.
Hard shots from Romanoff. Got a cover here. Bolshevik group doing some work to the back of the Mad Dog.
Alexis Windsor, what do you make of those you can't wrestle chants to Romanoff?
I mean, he's delivering some heavy blows right now. I'm not sure if I agree with that, but let's see what he's made of.
Well, look, it doesn't matter about how well he can wrestle. He's a striker.
He is raining those strikes down on Bill Gracie.
Look at this. The power of the Bolshevik group, and in comes the brains of the operation, the man with the plan,
Tandem offense here, whips Gil Gracie across and hits him with a double clothesline there. And signs of disrespect.
Here's Bujol, keeping everything copacetic.
Except I don't think there was a tag made. Koloff just came in the ring.
He said he heard him.
The crowd shouting, no tag, no tag.
I may have never seen a tag match before, Landon, but I think you're supposed to tag physically your opponent to be the legal man. So I don't think that was legal.
I don't think it was, but
if it wasn't legal,
the referee Jordy Peele, then he is legal.
Right? No, you're right.
If it wasn't legal, why is Jordy allowing it? Jordy's bad referee, I guess.
No, I just think Koloff's a cheater, which is
absolutely
nothing new.
And being someone who has refereed in the past, it's so hard to keep your eyes everywhere sometimes.
Wait a minute, we got a cover here.
Especially with a team like Koloff's on it.
Yeah, you're absolutely right. I mean, this is a lot to focus on. Six-man tag team main event. Gracie in the corner he does not want to be in.
Back in is Charles West. And look at these frequent tags here. In comes Romanov.
Yeah, Koloff's army working as a unit here against Gil Gracie.
Gil Gracie in possibly the worst position in the ring right now.
Could not agree more. He might as well be miles away from his corner.
Koloff's army working to eliminate the Mad Dog from the equation. Look at this, now hooks the leg.
He's gonna go for a third.
Legs. Two legs. What else can he hook? I think that's it.
You'd be surprised.
Bill Gracie back to his feet. Gets whipped into the turnbuckle, though.
Jordy got away just in time. You see that?
No kidding. And back into his team's corner.
Back into enemy territory. He's got to get back to make it.
A legal tag that time by Charles West gets Koloff in the ring. But Gracie fighting off now, seeing if he can make it back to his corner. But Koloff stops his momentum with a knee to the midsection, and he brings the Mad Dog down and then nails a big elbow drop. Cover with the forearm across the face. No, but that was close.
Deliver that elbow to a man that knows a thing or two about elbows.
Absolutely.
And just listen to the VFW Hall. The Pro Wrestling 225 family is coming alive for Gil Gracie. Now, double clothesline, both men down, center of the ring. Can Gil Gracie get to his corner and make that tag?
The fans here, our Pro Wrestling 225 family, trying to will Gil Gracie to his corner, to the Kings of Old School. Koloff gets the tag to Romanov. Gracie trying to get there.
We're gonna make
it. Does to Boudreaux. Oh, big clothesline. And another.
These hard shots from the legend himself, Blake Boudreaux. And now Romanov could be in trouble here.
Cover. And a kick out at two. But Alexis, it seems like momentum is shifting into the hands of the Kings of Old School.
Absolutely. And of course, now we have Mustang Mike in.
Tandem offense
working
here.
Working so well with Blade Boudreaux.
Absolutely. Well, like the name says, Kings of Old School, right? They have a lot of experience combined between the three of those men. They work similar styles. It makes sense that they are cohesive as a tag team.
Mustang, not.
Look at the strength.
Staying focused, doesn't matter what Koloff's army is doing. He's continuing to do that damage. Look at the power.
Josh Williams was impressed over here with that strength from Mustang. Mike, cover.
Only a two count, Romanov gets that shoulder up.
This is the momentum that we needed from the Kings of Old School, though.
Absolutely right. Things were looking awful Russian for a while there. And Romanov, just as I say that, big jawbreaker takes the big man, Mustang Mike, down. I say the big man, every man of this match is huge.
Yes.
I'd like to know the total combined weight on this one.
No kidding.
They didn't tell me. Perhaps to keep it a secret, I don't know. Maybe it's like a Russian secret, especially.
It feels that.
Yeah.
Romanov whips Mustang Mike across. Oh, and catches him with the clothesline. And just
hey, get off the throat. Come on now.
Blatant choke.
Didn't even try to hide that.
And another false tag, this time to be Charles West.
Man, it's so great to see Ivan Romanov in a Pro Wrestling 225 ring. You know, that man auditioned for Russian Idol.
Is that
back
true?
In the day.
Is that true?
There is.
What song did he sing?
Well, I believe it was the Russian national anthem.
Oh.
Memory serves. You can see how well it worked out for him. He's in the wrestling ring.
Yeah, I heard if you lose Russian Idol, you have to play Russian roulette. We're lucky he's here.
No kidding.
No one's rushing to play that one.
Big side slam by Koloff on Mustang Mike.
but there's still fight left in the Grand Slam champion of 225.
Another loud tag there to beat Charles West.
The Pride working in tandem. Couple of elbows.
Former tag champs going to work.
Leg drop
this
and splash combo.
Game over. And Mad Dog breaks things up.
Okay, Alexis, yes. While we have this moment, how many points does the team score if they get a touchdown? Can I give you a hint?
Five.
Okay, wait, let's look how many competitors are in this match.
Six!
There we go!
Yeah,
you know your stuff.
That was close,
you know your stuff.
All right, how many points do you get if you score the extra kick after a touchdown?
It is called an extra point.
One.
One! Alexis Windsor, as knowledgeable as they come. Charles West
gets it on the second try.
I'm so glad you allowed me multiple guesses.
Educated dropkick
there. Oh, most from Charles West.
Man, listen to this. BFW Hall, big USA champ, trying to get Mustang Mike back into it.
And Mustang Mike's taking a couple of hard shots to the spleen in this one. He's going to be feeling that.
To the spleen, huh?
You see what I'm seeing?
I've never seen a tag match before. It's all new to me.
That's true.
Hope that is not the same area. Understand?
Yeah, absolutely.
Whatever you say about him, it is a sound.
And Mustang Mike is in real trouble here. He's in the dead center of the ring. He's as far away from the ropes as he is from his teammates and any help he can get. He's going to have to try to shake Koloff off of him, but just as I say that, Koloff drives him right back down to the mat.
And that cool clutch
puts him right back in. And the leader of the Boom Nation.
Look at the torque across the neck. You can see the discoloration in the face of Mustang Mike. Take nothing away from this man. Look at him, how many times he's been able to get power out of this. But Koloff stomps him down, pushes him right back down to the mat.
And Mustang Mike is beginning to fade, it seems. But beating off of this capacity crowd.
And oh, goes to the well one too many times. Oh no. Koloff's in trouble.
Who would be the Russian for this? Not quite as valuable.
Excuse me. Up and what a slam.
But Mustang Mike on the wrong side of the ring. Can he cross Koloff and get to his corner?
That's a long way.
Tag goes into Romanoff. And there we go, Boudreaux also tagged in. Down goes Romanoff. Down goes West. There's an elbow for Koloff. Things are starting to break down here.
Here comes Gracie. This is a war. The main event of
six,
Honor and Pride.
All in the ring at the same time.
Oh! A little bit of a collision.
We need to remind the team.
And Vladimir Koloff just trying to take a swing.
Don't forget, Romanoff and Boudreaux are the two legal men still in the ring as things have really gotten crazy on the outside. Oh, a low blow! A low blow to Boudreaux. Our official is distracted with what's going on the outside.
But wait a minute. Keep your eyes on the prize here. Ivan Romanoff with the chain, but wait a minute.
Oh, Josh Williams.
Josh Williams is distracting him.
Throwing a football. He saw that chain. He didn't want Romanoff to use it. But it looks like it's working. Romanoff doesn't see Gracie behind him.
Better watch his back.
Spear! Spear! Down goes Romanoff.
Josh Williams with the assist. And now Blade Boudreaux.
Thank you.
teach you to mess with the honor and pride. That'll teach you to mess with the good old U.S. of A. The king of old school gets the job done, much to the dismay of our new SEC champion and his army. Look at this celebration with Chad Brown, Jeff Vance. Mustang Mike takes control with Gil Gracie and Blake Boudreau. The Kings of Old School get the win with the help of LSU star running back Josh Williams. Look at this celebration.
It does not get more patriotic than LSU football, I'll tell you that much.
What a moment in honor and pride. Just the way it should be.
What a night this has been. Honor and pride lived up to all the hype. Our thanks go out to the city of Gonzales. They packed the house here in the VFW Hall. What a night.
For Alexis Windsor and Landon Corbin, I'm Spencer Hunt. Next stop, Super Bowl 8.
Can't get much bigger than that.
And we will cover it right here on Unleashed.